Dear Nintendo, hi, it's me, Austin, and I'm here once again to take your cute, beloved franchise adored by millions and twist it until it's barely recognizable for both my own amusement and for the amusement of other cynical jerks out there like me. Recently, MatPat deduced that being a Pokemon trainer was the worst career move you could possibly make, and you know what? He's totally right. The boring, old, workaday trainer job is not only grueling, it's just not freaking worth it. Amazingly, though, in my own journey into the Pokemon universe, I discovered something that Matt missed. Something that, honestly, I think we all missed. I didn't see a single comment in that video about this. There is a secret loophole that if you're willing to forgo the normal path of wearing holes in the bottom of your shoes, walking miles down routes 1 through 17 in your quest to become the literal best Pokemon trainer in the universe, only to be rewarded with enough change to buy yourself a victory dinner and a cheap hotel room for the night, you can become the richest person in the entire world in practically no time at all and destroy entire nations in the process. And in order to do that, you're gonna have to do one simple thing. Get yourself a Pokemon that knows the move Payday. Matt gets a pass for missing this move because, well, for one thing, it kind of misses the spirit of the Pokemon games and the anime, which is to go on an adventure and enslave sentient creatures and force them to fight each other to the death for your amusement and profit. But I actually discovered this completely by accident. You see, my original goal, the original video I was going to do, was to figure out, of all 728 Pokemon moves, which was the most dangerous and damaging of them all. And I got all the way down the list to move six. Move six! Six entries in and I'm already distracted. Ah! I'm trying to figure things out, give the people the blood, gore, and horror that they want out of the game meant for children, and here I am, distracted by the jingling car keys of boy! I just gotta know how much money you can make from Payday. For the purposes of this video, we're gonna use the figure MatPat uses, where 100 polka dollars is 39 cents in US currency, which I did double check and seems to be on the level. Anyway, on with the show. How much money can you make using the move Payday? For those of you who don't know, Payday is a move learned almost exclusively by the Pokemon Meowth or their evolutionary forms. It's a physical, normal-type move where your Pokemon attacks your opponent by literally throwing money at them. As a nice bonus, at the end of the battle, you get to pick up all the money from the ground and keep it, providing you wipe the blood and fur of the murder victim off of it first. The way the amount is calculated is pretty simple. It's the level of your Pokemon times 5 per use. If you use it 3 times with a level 5 Meowth, that's 75 smackers. Use it once with a level 100 Meowth, boom! 5 hundo right in the pocket. All for the low, low price of a little bit of Pokemon PTSD. So basically, on that little bit of information right there, you can see that the goal to making a buck would be to simply have the highest level Pokemon use Payday the most in a short amount of time, right? And for the sake of simplicity, and to save room for later because I have a lot of info to get through today, let's run through it like this. You take a level 100 Meowth to a high level, like Pony Gauntlet, and start running in circles. Let's say that you have the ability Illuminate active, which doubles your encounter rate, and let's say you were even smarter and equipped an amulet coin to double the money you earn at the end of the battle, taking into account that each step takes exactly a fifth of a second. That means that it'll be approximately 1.077 seconds on average until you encounter a wild Pokemon, which will be around level 50 to 55. Boom! You two-shot it using Payday. The Pokemon dies without getting a chance to ride home to his family. Since you're level 100, you use Payday twice. That's 2,000 big ones right there, or $7.80, and then you rinse and repeat this over and over and over again. Given that the average battle would last approximately 42.83 seconds, plus the average of 1.077 seconds in between battles, this means that you're earning a cool 45.54 polka dollars, or 18 cents per second. That is a whopping $10.66 per minute, or $639.49 $0.25 per hour. That is over 28 times the average hourly wage in the United States, according to the U.S. Bureau of Labor Statistics. That means if you work 8 hours a day, 9 to 5, murder, genociding helpless Pokemon 5 days a week for a whole year, you'll make a salary of, get this, over $1.3 million a year. Boom! Suck on that, Elite Four. Instead of being the very best that no one ever was, I'm just gonna sit around in luxurious capitalist fashion and reap the fruits of my cute little cat's labor every day before going home to my glorious McMansion. Like, between being a nomad with aching feet and being a millionaire entrepreneur, I know which I would pick. But it doesn't stop there. Oh, no. Because a business is not a business if it cannot be scaled up. So, how do we scale this up? Well, for that, we're gonna have to turn to YouTuber Verlissifius the Third. I don't know how to say it. Anyway, he figured out a way to twist and exploit the world of Pokemon for his own personal gain in a truly magnificent fashion. Using a combination of the Pokemon Smeargle, who can learn a move called Sketch, which allows him to copy any move he wants, and the SOS mechanic from Ultra Sun and Ultra Moon allows you to build a Pokemon with the moveset Roost, Payday, Happy Hour, and False Swipe. Happy Hour doubles the amount of reward money that you receive from a battle, which combined with the amulet coin leads to a 4x money payout. Now we're cooking with gas! Whereas these combined skills allow you to maximize your payouts, Roost and False Swipe allow you to essentially prolong a battle for an eternity, forcing your opponent to call for help every turn while you mercilessly pelt them with money, turning the game from a cute visualization of cartoonish dogfighting into a sort of meat grinder simulator where you drop Pokemon in one end and pick blood-soaked money out the other. Eventually, you reach a maximum payout of 100,000 Pokedollars or 390 bucks, end the battle, collect your winnings, and start the process all over again. Now, we know that these battles happen in real time because time in the Pokemon world progresses at the exact same rate as our world, and amazingly, this streamlined process bumps your salary from a still pretty impressive $639.49 per hour to $1,217.64 per hour, or $2.4 million a year. That is quite the frickin' stack of cash. A suspiciously high stack of cash, which brings us back to what I mentioned earlier. And destroy entire nations in the process! Those of you who know a thing or two about economics know that money doesn't come from nowhere. And as far as I see it, the move Payday, a move that, remember, involves throwing a literal, valid, spendable currency at your opponent, acquires its money in one of two ways. Either A, it's a glorified printing press where whoever uses it is essentially pooping out fresh money on the fly, which means you're really gonna have to invest in some money laundering? Eh? Eh? Or B, it's teleporting valid currency from somewhere in the world into your Pokemon's hands. Essentially glorified theft, which, yikes. Now, I'm gonna be honest. According to my calculations, one person doing this would not negatively impact the economy one way or the other by all that much. Although, I'm sure it would definitely raise some eyebrows over at the IRS. But, if the chaotic windfall of bitcoins has taught us anything, where there's easy money to be made, short-sighted people will come rushing from all corners of the globe! There's a 100% chance, if this money-making scheme were discovered, it would not remain a secret. And in order to figure out the economic impact of this move, we're gonna have to figure out how many people are using it across the entire world of Pokemon. Now, it's hard to tell exactly how many people would catch wise, but we can build an approximation from the very video that outlines this method. As of this moment, the money-making guide by Verlissify has 1,900 likes on it, which is probably the closest estimate we'll get for folk who are playing Ultra Sun and Moon that are using this method. Now, hold on to your butts, because we're gonna use this one number, 1,900, and use it to blow your electrode. So considering that at least 1,900 people are presumably using this method to get rich in Ultra Sun and Moon, we need to figure out a few things. The population of the various Pokemon regions, their gross domestic product, or GDP, which is economic shorthand for how much money this country is worth, although that's a bit reductive and it's incredibly difficult to know for certain how much money is in the world, this is the closest thing to a real number we can use to estimate how big the giant pool of Pokedollars is. The Pokemon canon is comprised of 7 major regions: Kanto, Johto, Hoenn, Sinnoh, Unova, Kalos, and Alola, all of which are based off of real-world locations, almost to the exact layout. Kanto is the Kanto region of Japan, Johto is the Kansai region, Hoenn is the Kyushu, and Sinnoh is the Hokkaido region, while Unova is New York and New Jersey, and Kalos is France, and Alola, of course, is Iceland. Hawaii. Using the maps we have available, I overlaid them with the various regions in our real world they're based on to get estimates of their area, which we can use in conjunction with population densities to get an estimated population. Unova was the most difficult since the Hudson, Hackensaw, and the East aren't perfectly aligned with Unova, while Alola was the easiest since I could just copy and paste everything. Given the approximate population densities of each region the Pokemon ones are based on, and their square miles and kilometers, I determined that Kanto has a population of 738,000, Johto 894,000, Hoenn 987,000, Sinnoh 1.3 million, Unova 8.7 million, Kalos 547,000, and Alola 897,000, or a total population of 14.17 million in all the mainstay Pokemon games. Since 1,900 people is exactly 0.21% of the population of Alola, and I'm presuming for the sake of simplicity that this percentage of users remains consistent across region, means that in total there's approximately 29,993 people using the Payday, Happy Hour, Amulet, Pokemon genocide method of money making. But we're still not done yet, because while this is incredibly helpful in figuring out how much money is being created, it doesn't give us a sense for what the economic impact would be. For that, we need to multiply the GDP per capita, or the gross domestic product per person, for each person in each region according to the GDP of their respective countries, with the United States having the highest GDP PC of $57,015.66, followed by Japan with $38,889.76, and finally France with $36,846.04, which, when multiplied appropriately, gives us a total Pokemon GDP of 1.8 trillion Pokedollars, or 724 billion real-world dollars. Woo! Okay, got all that? Need a glass of water? I sure as hell do. All right. Our giant pool of money for the sake of this video is $724 billion, but we've got almost 30,000 people, or 0.21% of the population, working 8 hours a day, 5 days a week, to make the most money they possibly can. Which, interestingly, it's estimated that approximately 0.33% of the population is chasing Bitcoin, so this number holds up. So, let me kick you a scenario. You're the first person to discover this Pokedollar printing press method. You start making your thousands every day, and one day someone is like, "Hey, why do you seem so rich all of a sudden?" And you know, she's your best friend, so you decide, what's the harm in telling one person? So you give her the details and keep on going with your business, effectively printing your own money, and all the while, the online forums dedicated to Pokedollar mining are starting to stir. Creepy, scammy companies are starting to form. And suddenly, 1 year later, everyone's joining the HODL gang. Your secret is out, and now 30,000 people are murdering Psyducks on the daily to increase their Pokemon bank account size so they can creep ever closer to that elusive Poke Lambo. Presuming that this method prints money instead of, say, stealing it from old ladies a la teleportation, what does this mean? Inflation. With this many people printing this much money, you've grown from infusing the market with a mere $2,435,271.90 a year to a terrifyingly high $75,964,185,008.20 per year, creating, get this, an annual inflation rate of 10.48%, which is not great. A little inflation is a good thing. The United States Federal Reserve tries to keep it hovering at about 3% each year because it encourages spending and growth. 10.48%, though, would have a pretty negative impact on the economy. People would want to save money or even borrow money because $100 that they have in January would be worth $89.50 in December. We know for a fact that inflation like this is bad because it's the rate that our country hovered at during several bad economic crises in the past 50 years. While it likely wouldn't kill people, unemployment rates would rise, and the government would start investigating why inflation had creeped so high without their input. What markets are unmonitored and unregulated, they'd be asking?
That's a scam!
And boom! Suddenly you and your firm of 30,000 people are before a congressional ethics board, sanctions are being imposed, and blam! Payday grinding is outlawed.
Not the greatest outcome, but it's also by far not the worst. The worst thing that happens here is you, yourself, become the Bernie Madoff or Martin Shkreli of the Pokemon world. They'd write about you in textbooks for business 101 courses about the dangers of arbitrage chasing. It's not great, but at least you're still alive, and maybe you could get a killer book deal out of it. The same, however, cannot be said if Payday, instead of acting as a printing press, straight up steals money from somewhere. And honestly, knowing the way the Pokemon world works, this seems far more likely. I mean, how is a cat or whatever the hell Smeargle is, a Bob Rossian dog? Anyway, how are they capable of straight up making money out of nowhere? The logistics alone of keeping that much metal stored in their bodies for spontaneous synthesis is troubling. Whereas Pokeballs and other Pokemon like Abra, Kadabra, and Alakazam have proven that teleportation and casual quantum entanglement abuse is a regular thing in this universe. It makes much more sense that those Pokemon are teleporting money out of local cash registers, safes, banks, and mattresses into their hands to throw at their enemies. And holy crap, if this is the case, the whole frickin' world is screwed. Sure, at first, everything's hunky-dory, but after a few weeks of 30,000 people effectively stealing money from others, the world economy would start to collapse. I mean, just for a reference, the top 0.21% of the wealthy in America control a little over 11% of the wealth in the country. And conservatively, it took them, like, at least some years to get that wealth, probably decades. It would take the 0.21% of Pokemon trainers using these moves 282 days, just 10 months to be at the same level. And it would just go up from there. I mean, whatever your political leanings, look out your window, look on Twitter, things are, you know, not great right now. People are angry, some people want to protect their wealth, other people want to redistribute the wealth, and we're just here. We're right here where the top 0.21% controls 11.37% of the wealth. Can you imagine what it would be like if the 0.21% controlled, I don't know, a quarter of the wealth? Well, less than 2 years into our scenario, that's where we are in the Pokemon universe. Half the wealth? Less than 3.5 years! By the end of a 5-year period, if this pattern continued, the top 0.21% of the wealthy in the Pokemon world would control almost 3/4 of all the money in existence. There would be an unstoppable uprising, probably long before this point. Political inclination would hardly matter because everyone's on the same page when you're starving. Left wing, right wing, they'd all unite under the banner of cutting your freaking head off so they can afford to eat. Redistribution of wealth wouldn't even be a political policy issue. It'd be the meaning between life and death for 99.79% of the world population. And once 30,000 heads rolled, there'd undoubtedly be bloody civil wars as masses of hungry, desperate people with different life experiences and ideologies fought over how to distribute this money back to the people. It would be a war with death unlike we've ever seen. It'd be devastating, span entire continents, and cost the lives of millions of innocents. All because you didn't want to work for an honest living. So, sure, maybe Pokemon training isn't the best living, but it's a hell of a lot better than spending your life in prison or millions of people cheering as your head is chopped off. Be safe. Be responsible. Do not use Payday. And apparently, don't be a Pokemon trainer either. Just, like, be one of those dudes who owns a shop selling Pokeballs to 10-year-olds. It's so much safer. Sincerely, Austin.